organization of the details, how to survive this week. We are starting tomorrow with the hearings. And we are having most of the hearings in the Juridicum at the University of Vienna. And nowadays it's me who asked the university for additional rooms. We needed more rooms. It's the first time that we have more than 300 university teams participating in the Moot. Yes, I was really excited. So we have more hearings at the faculty building of the University of Vienna in the Schenkenstrasse. These are the rooms called SCH rooms. Then we have again hearings at two law firms, Todorov-Gershordis and Baker McKenzie. We thank them a lot for supporting us again and hosting the hearings in the law firms. The arguments begin tomorrow at 8:30 in the morning. If you're not scheduled in the morning, sleep longer. It's a little bit hectic the very first day at the Juridicum, and we have the main meeting area there at the top floor. It's called Dachgeschoss, so it's your first German lesson, Dachgeschoss. That's where we all meet, that's where the registration takes place, but you can do the registration the entire day. So sleep longer if you do not have to get up in the morning. We are opening at 8 o'clock for the first hearing round at 8:30. So it's important that arguments begin on time. Look that you are there 50 minutes earlier, that we can keep the time schedule. We have then the arguments in a row of 2 hours, so at 10:30 the next one, 12:30, 14:30 and 16:30 is the last round. If you are in the Dachgeschoss, there are many publishers presenting books in the area of international arbitration, commercial arbitration, investment arbitration, and international sales law. Take your time, have a look at the books. They're excellent books, and you might even have the opportunity to meet the authors. Many of these authors are also participating as arbitrators in the Moot. There will also be a breakfast corner, friendly supported by the VIAC. I would also advise you, go there, if you are a morning person. You have the opportunity to meet the secretary people there, Manfred Heider or Elise Gregor-Wolf and other supportive members of the secretariat and the presidium. Take your time, talk to them. You are now specialists on the Vienna rules. You can exchange ideas with them how to apply the rules. There is also what we organize on Sunday. This is something new. We are organizing a photo booth. So you might like to have a photo together with your team, or you have already made friendship with another team from 11 to 13. 100 hours, we have there the possibility that you make photos, and they will be available then on the internet that you can purchase them. I think the price is not, it's about 3 to 5 euros a photo, so it's quite affordable. At the Dachgeschoss and at the law firms, arbitrators receive the scoring sheets. We will ask them to have them in again immediately after the sessions, that we can count every score you get, and we will hand out also the awards banquet tickets for the arbitrators. This will be in the Juridicum. Arbitrators can have them already from tomorrow. For the teams, we will hand them out together with the certificates for participation starting on Monday from 11 on. Arbitrators are invited to see us, that we can schedule them for additional hearings. There are a few short withdrawals, and we are happy to schedule replacement arbitrators. We are also happy if you notify us if you're in the Juridicum or at one of the law firms at the Schenkenstrasse, and would be willing to be a reserve arbitrator for a round. Then we would ask you to notify the staff there. We have staff at every location, and they will be happy to ask you if somebody is not showing up and has not notified us before. Again, I think, Chris, you would be also happy to hear today from some arbitrators if they notify you in regards to additional hearings. The teams, we would like to notify them specifically again of a certain rule. Teams may listen to other hearings, yeah, but not those of teams against which you're scheduled to argue. This is a very important rule, and we ask you to obey that. And this does not only apply to the team members, but also of accompanying persons of these teams, friends, relatives. Yeah, this is really important because it would have the consequence if you do it, also inadvertently, that you would not be allowed to proceed to the elimination rounds, although you would have the scores sufficiently. So, besides these organizational details, I really wish you a pleasant week. Take the opportunity. It's not only a pleasant atmosphere, it's also your first step, probably, step in a professional atmosphere, starting building up your network, and it might be your first step to build your network that supports you for many, many years. I can tell you, I know so many people where the Moot has changed their lives. Maybe you're one of them. And it changes your life to a very positive extent. I hope you have a pleasant week. Thank you.
If we bought our soul in another state, we didn't know what the law would be. haven't gone in US courts, just treated by VUCC. As a young man, I took up those words my daddy said. I became a merchant, traded goods to earn my bread. But I would not buy or sell beyond the borders of my state. Cause if the deal was not domestic, none could tell my evil fate. We didn't have no CISG. We were clueless how the law would go if we dealt internationally. But now under this treaty, global commerce, it's a breeze. Except some jerks from Pittsburgh and Denmark say I can't recover no attorney fee. Sell a farm. I can deal with folks from everywhere, from Isles to Zanzibar. And the goods I buy, well, they're always fine, and my buyers, they never sue. You know, I hardly need a lawyer. Yes, my life's perfection true. Because we have that CISG. There's no risky international sales far as the eye can see. But I just received a shipment. So I must quickly say goodbye, because German courts and the Austrians too give me just 5 minutes to inspect and notify. Favorite of all time song about an international commercial entry. In fact, I even hold out hope that someone out there might want to listen to it again, and if you do, you should go to the website of the Center for International Legal Education at the University of Pittsburgh. That's the CILE, and there you can listen to a recording of the song, and you can find the lyrics of the song, print it out, and quite proud of this, properly footnoted. The Center for International Legal Education at the University of Pittsburgh was founded and is directed by my very good friend, who happens to be my extraordinarily distinguished colleague and the co-coach of the University of Pittsburgh team, Professor Ronald Brand. Amazingly distinguished career in which he has made only one serious error of judgment, and that was putting my song on his website. We all make mistakes. Usually I write a song based on each year's problem to perform here at the opening ceremonies, but this year the plan was a little different. It became different when I made a very interesting discovery while I was secretly examining the confidential electronic records of claimant and respondent. You may wonder what I was doing, secretly examining the party's confidential electronic records, but the answer is quite simple. I am trained in US-style discovery. I think it is my absolute right to look at any dang document I want to, any time I want to, for any reason whatsoever. And besides, with electronic records, unauthorized access is not really a big problem as long as you have a friend at the US National Security Agency. So there I was one afternoon, out of idle curiosity, just kind of, you know, rummaging around in the party's confidential electronic records without their permission. And I came upon something very interesting. I discovered an audio file containing a recording of a hitherto undisclosed meeting between respondent and claimant. A meeting that occurred just as the dispute in our problem was beginning to heat up. Just as it was starting to become clear that claimant would demand more wine than respondent was willing to deliver. And the most amazing thing about this meeting was, whenever anybody at the meeting had anything to say, they sang it. Lucky break for me, because I figure I don't have to write a song about this year's problem. I will just bring the recording here to the opening ceremonies. I will play it for this audience, which of all audiences in the world is likely to find it at least possibly interesting, maybe even entertaining. And I forgot the recording. I left it at the hotel. It's the ravages of age on one's memory. But you know what? I think I have just enough still functioning memory cells left to be able to reproduce for you here tonight that musical meeting between responding and playing. Let me see, if I recall correctly, the meeting opened with Mr. Friedensreich, claimant's Mr. Friedensreich, setting forth for the benefit of respondents representatives at the meeting, claimant's position regarding its order of wine that year. Mr. Friedensreich sang, 10,000 bottles of your wine on the wall. 10,000 bottles of your wine. If one of those bottles should happen to fall, ship me the remaining 9,999. And you'll still owe me one. I know your customers fight for supplies that are tight and demand a sword over the moon. But if you're asked who gets what he wants, you should have just one response. Heed the following tune. It has to be me. Who gets your inventory? Treat your other patrons like deadbeats and bums. Send all your wine to me. Or for an injunction, I'll sue. And claim the damages too. For the profits that you got, and to pay for my lawyer's new yacht. That's what I'll do. If you think that's a bluff, and you won't ship enough, you'll have tears in your eyes when you realize my lawyers will grind you to dust. So have a glass of mothballs and diamond quality if you have any left when you're done shipping to me. It has to be me. Wonderful me. It's your inventory. And at that point in the meeting, Mr. Weinbauer, then CEO of his life, delivered the following musical reply to Mr. Friedman. Why, you pathetic lackey. You think you can scare me? Your demand is forbid by using to trade in the wine industry. I'm Florence's finest wine. I'm God's gift to mankind. Why, you'd be lucky to swill the dregs that I spill, you malodorous swine. Are you out of your mind? On drugs of some kind. You should be grateful to get any quantity I set, and then you can kiss my knee. Love it fine. And we can play doctor with our business records. I'll show you mine if you show me yours. But there was a silver lining. You see, all the lawyers got fees. So raise a glass if you know a Veritas and smile. Savor its notes of rancor and bile. and drink to our fees, our wonderful fees, our, dare I say it, not recoverable as damages under Article 74 of the CISG.
Passport, trumpet, and a boner, and Oscar is where they sing. much, Eric. Thank you for making it so easy for me. In principle, I just wanted to apply the so-called KISS principle. You have heard from your coaches several times. Keep it short and simple. However, I was told that the Mater Veltin has not the right temperature yet. So I have to keep your attention for some minutes at least. And probably the only way for me to do that is to talk a little bit about the problem. To be honest, I thought it was a very easy problem. Clear-cut division between procedural law and substantive law. So I was really surprised when I got this 2,400 requests for clarification. I had the impression it was more like 5,000 of them, but allegedly only 2,400. I tried to answer them all. I tried hard. There was, however, one question which I couldn't answer. And I read it out to you, perhaps someone can later on help me and provide the necessary information. There was one team who wanted to know about Miss Bukharit's medical record. We want to know about her eyesight to establish the validity of the testimony. So probably the only one who knows what her mental status is Harry Fleschner, who seems to have very good friends at some American associations. But now let's come to the more substantive part. You always heard from your coaches, never make more than three submissions. The first submission is on costs. Those of you who will make it to the final will meet Harry Fleschner as one of the arbitrators in the final. You just heard about his position on lawyer's fees and Article 74. Now I reveal a secret to you. When he wrote that article, he was young and needed the money. That this is primary an educational exercise. It's not a competition. So if on Tuesday evening you're not one of the unlucky teams who have to compete, continue to compete, if you then have the feeling that you are not a winner, the burden of proof is upon you. There's a hardly rebuttable presumption that everyone who has participated here is a winner. And last but not least, discovery. You know, the Americans have the concept of discovery of documents. Here in Vienna, we also have a concept of discovery. But it means discover Vienna. There are no documents. There's a lot of Mater Veltin around, a lot of non-alcoholic Mater Veltin around as well. And there is a group of students, arbitrators, coaches, who are definitely more worth talking to than reading through the discovered documents. So that is our position on discovery. And last but not least, it's a great pleasure to have you all here. It's for us always, after all the work we put into that, the most rewarding moment to stand in front of all of you and see that despite all the headaches we gave you, you still listen to us. Thank you very much. And now comes the most interesting part of my speech. I declare the buffet open. I hope that the Mater Veltin team now has the right temperature. And I hope to see a lot of you in the Dachgeschoss approach us if you have any problems, if you want to discuss anything apart from the real problem. We're happy to discuss everything. And I wish you, on behalf of my two co-directors and all the other organization team, excellent mood, enjoy it, and have fun. Thank you.